guys, welcome back to another Cascade Critters video. Thanks for watching my last reptile room tour video. I appreciate all the feedback and the comments I got back. It was super positive. So today's video is going to be a video on setting up a bioactive setup as well as just the benefits of a bioactive setup. I have been using a bioactive setup for the past year with my crested geckos, and I've been loving it so far. My bioactive setups are all live planted, and you know, I just think it's better for the animals. It's more healthy for them, it's more natural. You know, there's a lot of benefits to it. Those are just a few. We'll get into all the benefits in a bit. The only drawback that I see is just the cost. The startup cost can kind of be a few hundred dollars. It can be less than that, like easily, but really to do it really nicely, you know, it's gonna cost you a bit. It really depends on the size of tank you have and really what kind of isopods and springtails and stuff you wanna buy. I know some of the more expensive isopods can get into the $50 and $60 range. And if you have a bigger tank and you have to buy more than just like one colony of isopods, then you know, there can go $100 right there just for a colony of bugs. So, you know, it can get quite expensive, but it just depends how you want to do it. But what I have done is I've just bought a few colonies of springtails and a few colonies of dwarf white isopods, and I've just put those in various tanks, and now I have like an abundance of isopods. I'll show you, this is one of the colonies that I've kind of picked out just for this video. But I'm gonna raise this colony up and then I'm already producing my own springtails, but you know, this will be kind of one of my bigger colonies that I have. These are kind of what isopods come standard in, same with springtails. They'll just come in like a 3-ounce deli cup. You can buy these at reptile expos, or you know, there's various vendors who sell them in general. And we have a cat. Get away, cat. Get away. So you can buy these from, you know, all different people. A lot of pet stores and stuff like that don't really sell them. I've rarely seen them at pet stores. Some more like specialized reptile pet shops usually have them. But you know, just like your regular pet store, like PetSmart, Petco, aren't gonna have these. Like, and the employees there, I'm guessing most of them aren't gonna know what you're talking about when you say, I want isopods, I want springtails. Like, you're not gonna get a response. So yeah, but if you go to any reptile expo, they will definitely have these there. You know, it's kind of confusing if you go to a reptile expo and you say, I want isopods, because there's so many different types and, you know, genetic differences. And he probably has 100 different types of isopods that he sells, ranging from like $10 upwards to like $100 on the more expensive end. And really the only difference is the size of them. Some are like a lot bigger than others. And the other difference is like coloration. Like you can get some really crazy colors, like yellow and purple ones and blue ones, like really crazy colors. But if you're just starting out and you want to do this on the cheap, this is kind of the cheapest way, in my opinion, that you can do it. What I have is dwarf white isopods. From what I have seen, they usually range from like $10 to $15 for a colony of 10 to 20. The ones I bought were at the Reptile Expo, and I think I paid $10 and it was a colony of 10. So I think that was pretty fair. And the thing you have to realize too is that when you put these in your tank, especially if you have multiple colonies, like let's say you bought like 2 or 3 colonies of them, so that's like 30, they're gonna breed really quickly and reproduce really quickly. So in a matter of months, you're gonna have a lot of them. With a colony of springtails, you'll probably have hundreds in there. Like I can't really show you springtails on camera because they're like microscopic. They're tiny, tiny little things. But you, when you have a colony of springtails, you'll be able to tell they're in there because there's just hundreds of them. And a colony of springtails will usually be in, they're in charcoal usually. And you just dump the whole thing in the tank that you want them in. And obviously the bigger tank you have, the more they're gonna reproduce and the quicker as well, because you give them more space. So they're gonna produce quicker. So you're never gonna really know exactly how many are in there, but you know, you can make a good judgment by just like, you know, taking a scoop out and just, you know, kind of digging through and finding all of them. And in the tanks, they're gonna be in different spots because they are obviously gonna go where different food is and stuff like that. So you may not be able, you're not gonna see them. That's one thing that is, I think, really cool and awesome is that you have like this mini ecosystem in a tank. You know, everything from your live plants to the crested geckos to the little bugs that eat up all the poop and do everything. It's kind of a full cycle. And I just think it's really neat to see that and be able to experience that and recreate like what they would have exactly in the wild. I don't see any negative downside to it, other than if you're doing it improperly. There's lots of plants out there that are not safe for reptiles. Lots of plants that flower in the summertime or flower at any time of the year really can produce sap, especially tropical ones. And a lot of those are toxic to geckos and toxic to reptiles in general. So, you know, obviously those ones you don't want to give to your reptile. You want to give them ones that are non-toxic and ones that aren't going to hurt them, like pothos plants, spider plants, different plants like that. You can buy a lot of different plants from just like your home garden center. Just like there's apps and even just Googling, you can find out when you go to the store, like just find out which plant it is. And then you can just Google safe for reptiles. And a lot of the time you'll be able to find it on like a lot of forums. Like the Pangea forum has a lot of helpful information about plants, and there's websites even that are just all about safe reptile plants. So there's a lot of different places to find information, and like sometimes you'll go and you won't really be able to find an answer if it is safe or not. So when that happens, I just tend not to get that plant and choose something else that I know is safe, because you want to be 100% sure. Like, there is some plants that produce flowers that are safe, but you know, to be on the safe side, just make sure that whatever you put in your reptile tank is safe, because you know, you don't want your animal dying. That would not be fun. So the care for isopods is super easy. There is not much that you need to give them or provide them, but there is a few things that I would personally recommend just so that them reproducing and them having just like a better quality of life and just making it easier for you so that they actually clean up the poo and, you know, it speeds things along. These are a few things that I would recommend. So the first thing that I would recommend is some leaf litter. You can buy these at most pet stores. Sometimes they're called like Indian leaves, but for the most part, they're called leaf litter, and they all just look like this. They're pretty much just like dried brown leaves, but isopods like will hide underneath this. They'll also just eat it. It's another like food source if there's not really any poop for them to eat, or like dead leaves or dead matter that they can eat. This is a really good thing to just give them. You know, and it just gives them a little hiding space to hide underneath. And second thing I recommend is if you have a gecko, it depends on how many geckos you have in the tank, but if you only have one or two geckos and you have a whole colony of isopods and springtails, or one or the other, I would recommend adding some extra food for them just so that they're not totally reliant just on the gecko's poop. You can add just different stuff, like, you know, small pieces of banana peel, or just like apples, like apple slices, or like the skin off an apple. Like, it's really simple what you need to give them, but just give them something a little extra. If you have your tank that's has all live plants in it, then, you know, when the leaves and stuff die, you can just put those on the bottom and that should be enough. But just make sure that there's enough food for them in there to eat, because they will get hungry if you don't have enough food in there for them, and they will start dying off if you don't give them enough food. And the main thing that you want to do is have like a lot of them in there. The more the better, because then the poop just gets cleaned up super fast, and it speeds everything along. You know, it just makes it so much easier. So that's one thing that I really recommend. If I'm comparing a bioactive setup to just, let's say, a setup that someone has that they've just bought all the stuff from the pet store, like plastic plants and, you know, just regular hides and different stuff like that, there's a lot of stuff that you can do with live plants and a bioactive setup that you can't do necessarily with fake plants. Whoa. You guys hear that truck? Someone just started the truck and it was super loud. So like with fake plants, it's not as enjoyable as a life for your animal, because, you know, it's not what they would have in the wild. In the wild, they would have lots of trees, lots of live plants to jump on. You know, there's an abundance of life outside of their tank. Outside of just like their living space. They can go anywhere they want to, they can roam. So as much as you can, you want to recreate that. So by putting a bunch of plastic plants in your tank, it's not necessarily bad. Like, that's awesome. It's better than having nothing. But if you can have the choice of putting a live plant in your tank, which will eventually grow and really fill up your tank and really just fill up the space in that tank, you know, I would way rather choose that. And, you know, a lot of people always say, oh, it's super expensive to do this, blah, blah, blah. You know, you can go buy a pothos plant for like, what, $5-$10 at the store. What I basically do is a lot of my plants all just pot in cork bark, because I think it gives it a really nice naturalistic look versus just like a plastic potting plant. You know, it looks a lot better, and especially with like bigger plants that, you know, have a lot of roots and stuff, they can really grow into the cork bark, and really it just gives such an awesome look. I'll show you guys. You know, like, I've heard a lot of people say they don't really like live plants, and I don't really understand it, because, you know, it looks so awesome. Like, I don't really like plastic fake plants. Don't look that bad, but compared to live plants, you know, there's something live there and it looks so naturalistic and it looks awesome. I have lots of tanks that have that, and there's lots of animals that don't really do well with a bioactive setup. For instance, like bearded dragons, leopard geckos, you know, a lot of desert type animals don't really do well with bioactive setups. So with those animals, you don't really have a choice. So with that, you know, I'd rather you put plastic plants in there than not put anything at all, because you're at least giving your animals some enrichment. But if you have the choice between live plants and fake plants, I think you should go with live plants 100% of the time. Like, it's cheap, it's cheaper. Like, a plastic plant at the pet store is like over $10 easily. Live plants, like, you can, especially with like something like a pothos plant. And I know I'm mentioning pothos plant a lot in this video, but it's just a plant that I like a lot. But with that plant, you can even, like once it starts to really grow out, you can even cut off the leaves and then repot those, and those will grow into more plants. So you can regenerate the plant like multiple times over. So yeah, maybe you spent like $5 or $10 on a really nice, healthy, big plant, but you can repot that like multiple times and cut off the leaves and have like 5 or 6 different plants eventually. An investment that's really worth it. And that's the thing too, is like when you have a bioactive setup, all these things reproduce and you can just reuse them. So maybe you bought one colony of springtails or one colony of isopods. Those will eventually regenerate and, you know, be double, triple, quadruple, and eventually just like keep producing. So even if you just have them in one tank, you'll eventually be able to take the isopods that are in one tank and put them in another tank and another tank and another tank. So, you know, it's really helpful. So I don't really see a lot of negative to it. Obviously the only one is the initial cost, I guess. But if you compare it to what it would cost for enrichment in a regular tank with fake plants, you know, you're looking at a comparable cost. So that's pretty much the basics of springtails and isopods. I mean, you don't really need to know a lot to take care of them. They are really self-sufficient. Like, really, all you do is put them in the tank and they will stay alive, even if you're not giving them, like, food or whatever. Like, let's say there's no crested geckos or, like, no animal inside the tank. They can live off, like, the dirt and just matter that is in the tank. Especially if you, like, have plants that you have and like the leaves die, if you just put those in the tank with like, just let's just say you just have springtails in a tank, like they'll be able to survive off that no problem. But I mean, the main point of having isopods, especially for me, is just a cleanup crew for my crested geckos, because my big tank there has 4 crested geckos in it, and you know, that's a lot of poop to have to clean up. So I put these in there and I don't have to ever really clean the tank. I spot clean the glass because crested geckos obviously just make a mess with their food, but I don't really do anything besides that. Now I'm going to just show you some of the ideas I have for live plants and a bioactive setup. I will be showing you my tank and all of the live plants I have in it, as well as a few colonies of my isopods. So this is my live planted tank. It's kind of messy right now just because I've had a few plants die recently, but you know, there's a lot of healthy plants in here. That plant back there is my pothos plant. The thing that I like to do is put like, you get these little labels with every plant that you buy, and I just like to stick them in the tank so that you know what every plant is, and it, you know, it gives a kind of cool look to it. That plant in the back I've had for over a year, and I've replanted multiple other plants off of it, so it's more than paid for itself. I think I paid $5 for it, or even less than that. Like, it was super cheap. So this is what I mean about planting your plants in cork rounds. The alternative obviously is those little plastic cups that they give you when you buy your plants. Obviously this is a little bit more expensive, considering cork round is like probably $5 or $10 for a round. So if you're looking at like the plant plus the cork round, you're looking probably somewhere between $15 and $20 for this whole setup. But I just think it looks super naturalistic and awesome, especially in a bioactive setup. Oh, there's a little crested gecko. That's not my Dalmatian. So the last thing I want to kind of show you guys is just what a colony of isopod kind of looks like. You can see those little bugs running around in there. If we kind of shake it up a little bit, you'll see how many there are in there. I would say there's probably 25 to 30 in here, although you can't really see them because they're hiding in the dirt, but there's quite a few. This colony is from one tank that I have, and the colony that I put in there in the beginning had 10 in it, and this is just a few that I picked out, so you can imagine how many are actually in that tank. So it's crazy to just see how fast they reproduce. And I, you know, even just digging them out, I was really surprised at how many there were. And considering I've only had them in there a few months, it's really surprising. Even though it shouldn't really be surprising, because, you know, that's what isopods do. They breed and they produce. So that's what they are. Thanks again for watching the video, guys. Make sure you subscribe, as I'll be having more content like this in the future. I found it super helpful when people gave me tips and little hints for my reptile room, so I'm hoping to pass on some of that information and knowledge. And be sure to like the video if you learned something and you would like to see more videos like this in the future. I hope to see you guys next time, and have a great day.